The night is when magic awakens. When the sun is gone and darkness shrouds the world, the moonlight begins its story. When the sea and sky are united by the color of night, the dream sprawls its wings to travel freely across its wondrous, limitless realm. And the wizards, the sages of the night, one of the reasons I adore the city so. There were times when all stars here bore a name of their own. Grand bookshelves in the libraries, observatories spired in the night sky, paralleled in height only by the wizard's knowledge and wisdom. Cookies, created by the wizards, gained a shining purpose to serve their creators as aids in the search of truth. Yet, all is now nothing more than echoes of the past. When I close my eyes, my memories take me to a time when I wasn't alone. And those long gone are back as though they have never left. Is this but a dream? Or am I awake now? Will they return if I wait long enough? My name is Moonlight Cookie, the custodian of the City of Wizards. Who goes there? Who? Are you too an apparition of my dreams? Or perhaps...
This place is...
Precisely! Not a single cookie in sight! The whole place is running on magical contraptions! The great magical civilization and all the wizards... Poof! Gone! They call it one of the seven mysteries of Earthbread! We finally arrived at the legendary City of Wizards!
Huh. Who'd have known we'd have to get kicked out of a train for that?
I like the train. It brought us all the way here.
Right. Remind me to thank Milky Way Cookie if we ever see her again.
The moon looks so big here. Is that because the whole city is so empty?
According to the Annals of Magic, this place was chosen by the wizards because this is where the moon is the biggest, meaning that its arcane powers are the strongest here. It took several dozens of mathematicians to calculate this sweet spot, but thanks to their efforts, we can read at night without the need for any candles or lights.
Whoa! Does it mean that even the starry sky is a part of this place? The City of Wizards is even cooler than I thought! They've been following us for a while now, and I don't think they want to become friends.
They are the wizards' inventions, crafted to resemble the stars. To them, we are trespassers. Better be on our guard.
They're after us! The light burns my
to me.
I will not falter!
Hearken to me! I need a drink!
I will not falter!
The light guides my hand!
Right, that's down!
I will gladly return this favor.
peace! It's impolite to attack your guests.
We don't have anything to prove that. If only we could meet Moonlight Cookie first.
Right! We must hurry up and find Moonlight Cookie!
I will not falter! I will not falter!
The light guides my hand!
Hearken to me!
I will not falter!
I need a drink!
Right, that's
down! I will not falter!
The light guides my hand!
Hearken to me!
Let's take some time to savor this moment.
Ours is the side of the righteous.
My, my, would you look at this sight?
Do you see anything?
Come up here. You can see the whole city from this hill.
Whoa! Oh. I can't believe there's no one left in this place. If it were up to me, I'd call it the City of Night Sky.
And if it were up to me, the City of the Crescent. Look! All the way over there! The statues we passed on our way here! Is that where we took the train?
Seems so. How do we manage to cross the dream to get here? Wait a minute. We were walking in circles around the statues, then we, ended up at the train station?
The more you think about it, the weirder it gets. Perhaps that's the nature of the dream. The power of the slumbering moon makes it all possible. After all, Moonlight Cookie is the master of dream magic.
Over there! Moonlight Cookie!
She's asleep. I almost hate to wake her up. The moon is so bright and pretty. Why does she look so sad?
She must feel so lonely watching over the city all by herself. Think how long she must have been waiting for us.
Well, not that long, if you think of it. After all, she must have lived for much, much longer than us.
But...
And it is said that while Moonlight Cookie is asleep, no force can harm the Realm of Dreams. Her power is way too great for an ordinary cookie. And that's why we need her help.
But Moonlight Cookie herself asked for our help. There's got to be something we can do for her. Though, how do we wake her up?
There have got to be hints somewhere in this great city. Looks like we have our mission.
I will not falter!
Drink!
The light guides my
hand! To me!
I will not falter!
I need a drink!
Right, that's dumb!
I will not falter!
Hearken to me!
The light guides my
hand!
Right,
that's down!
Ours is the side of the righteous.
I will not falter!
Drink. Down.
The light guides my hand!
Hearken to me!
I will not falter!
Right,
I need a drink!
Rest assured, I've documented everything with utmost precision.
I will not falter!
Right, that's down!
I need a drink!
I will not falter! I will not falter!
I need a drink!
I will not falter!
I need a drink!
This is a victory for all of us.
By my hat! Not even in my wildest dreams did I imagine visiting the Arcane Planetarium!
Planetarium?
An artificially crafted model of the night sky. The wizards did love their stars, huh?
Crafted night sky? What does this even mean?
You'll understand once you see it with your own eyes. Let's hurry and get inside!
Oh, Wait up! These stairs are too tall.
Falter!
Right,
I need a drink!
Down.
I will not falter!
Hearken to me!
The light guides my
hand! I need a drink!
Right, that's down!
I will not falter!
Hearken to me!
Let's take some time to savor this moment.
Pretty cool, huh?
Whoa! I don't even know the words to describe this. A sky within the city. And there's giant balls floating in that sky. They look like they'll crash into each other, but they don't. What in the world?
Ahem. Those giant balls represent stars in the sky. While they might look like tiny dots to us, they actually look like that. Or so they say. These stars are created to look exactly like the real ones. And it's all powered with intricate magic spells. And just like trains, each star in the sky travels along its very own invisible road. That's why they never crash into each other.
How do you know all that, Wizard Cookie?
Well, I've read about it in my books. But enough talk. I am super psyched to see it with my own eyes! I could try and make one sphere float in the air, but the wizards created this whole place! And to think that these spheres have been floating here all this time without a single error! It is said that wizards and stars always go hand in hand. Here you understand why. The wizards of old were crazy about the sky! Do you know which star is my favorite? The star called Chaco Major, over there, that always shines so bright. Gorgeous, isn't it?
Wow, it really is big and bright.
And what are these pictures here?
These are called constellations. Have you ever noticed how some groups of stars look just like animals or objects?
Oh, this one is Jelly. That one is Cake Hound. And over there is Sugar Swan's son. Oh, so pretty! I love this place.
Look, another cinema! Let's climb on that chair and watch the movie.
For eons, the wizards and witches relied upon the powers of the moon, an everlasting source of arcane energy. But what is it that makes the moon so special? Some theorists claim the moon is constituted of cheese. Others speculate that the connection with the enigmatic rabbit was finally established. Here, in the City of Wizards, we step beyond tenets and theories to reveal the true potential of lunar magic. We bake cookies.
Nothing is impossible in the realm of dreams. It is a well-known fact. Ergo, at the intersection of the night, the moon, and the dream, magic unbound by all limits is born. The 12 Archmages' work has finally borne fruit. Now, the pristine life syrup and the dough of the dreams shall rest and dream until dawn, absorbing the mysterious lights of the night sky.
The whole world stands still in anticipation of the first cookie blessed with ingredients of celestial bodies, Will the world of dreams at long last reveal its secrets? The only being capable of providing an answer is the Moon Reborn in the form of a cookie.
You shall journey through the world we dare not explore. Now, the time to open your eyes has come.
Exploring the world of dreams? Does this mean a cookie like me can travel inside Ginger Brave's head?
Huh? Whoa! We could meet and play there. But are dreams meant to be shared? What if the wizard cookie from my dreams isn't the real wizard cookie? Oh, I think I'm getting a headache.
I wonder what happened to that cookie.
I am reading.